Hey, hello, Ryan. Paul McLean again. Take two here. This is the reflection. So the difference is going to be mid-profile versus full profile. The Solitude I sent you prior to this is 8 inches wider, 8 or 9 inches wider, and weighed about 12,000 pounds. This is going to be about 1,200 pounds lighter than that and a little bit more narrow. Same size panel, though. This is the one that I think is actually labeled 370 watts on this. Still wired into an inverter and a charge controller for you. Still a 50 amp camper with two ACs, still a fully walkable roof. It's about 2 feet longer though. So a little bit longer, a little bit less wide, and about 1,200 pounds and probably $15,000 to $18,000 less than the Solitude. So we'll kind of compare the two, and what's good for you is good. So the roof is the same. It's R40 insulation factor, 18 year warranty, fully walkable, as again are the slide outs and attic vent, which is really nice to have. A lot of companies don't do that. Just like a house, they put a kind of a venting attic for moisture to escape. And two great big awnings. This time I can put them all the way out for you. So let's go downstairs and look at that. The antenna is the same. That's the WineGuard Air 360. Same company that I think Musk is partnering up with on the motion sensor, the motion satellite for Starlink. So that's a good sign. This one will have the backup camera already installed. Probably that Solitude did as well. I didn't notice. Same hitch in the back, same weight rating. This, however, is one of the few couples floor plans, meaning not a bunkhouse, that has outside kitchen and entertainment. The little blue hose you might have noticed in the storage bin, that prior one, that's what pops into here for a little power washer. And this one will have two burner stove, mini refrigerator, and a Roku smart TV outside. So that's, again, kind of unique for a couple's floor plan. Now you can see both awnings. Interior storage would be a little bit different. So the difference between the wide body and the full profile versus mid profile, this frame is the same depth front to back, where the full profile, the frame drops down about 18 inches right here and then continues. So that's why the storage on that Solitude's a little bit deeper, taller. Both will have, so I failed to show you, but that Solitude will have a washer dryer connection, but it would be in the kitchen just for a combo washer dryer. This one you could put, if you wanted to, a side-by-side washer dryer. So here's the interior on this one. Pretty much the same. No, I think those other recliners were electric. These are manual. Four top there. That sofa thing here, what do you call those? No, I can't remember. Anyway, that'll slide out, go in front of your couch for you. And that way it could be just a two top, because this pops right off and goes under your bed. So if you just wanted a chair on each side, you could do that. And that is storage, of course. If you never needed the desk, this is just added kitchen counter space, because you have 110 and USB there, and then more 110 up here. Light switch up here. A little bit smaller refrigerator freezer, but not that much smaller. Just a side-by-side instead of a basement fridge. The oven is smaller. It's kind of the standard RV oven now. Three burner range instead of four. And a 30-inch microwave, but it's not convection. Those are some of the differences. The Solitude had the flush mounting floor on both sides. The Reflection has the lip on this side. Slightly smaller TV, but same brand, same smart TV. Slightly smaller fireplace, but the same brand. It's Still get a nice pantry. Still get plenty of counter space. Again, 110s everywhere you need it. The couch will make into bed if you ever had guests. In that Solitude, there's an option for just a big long couch that makes into a bed instead of the recliner table chairs, but I don't think, personally, I don't think that's the way to go. Upstairs on this one, this is the 320 MK again. Nice one-piece shower, slightly less fancy shower head, still a porcelain toilet, still a big sink with lots of storage. This one is similarly equipped with a king bed. Second AC, of course. And you've got your dresser drawers. Place for a TV, but doesn't come with it in the bedroom. It's easy to put one on though, figure about 300 bucks. Motion sensor lights. And a really nice closet on this one. I would hate to put a washer dryer in this and take up half the space, but it's able to, if that's your thing. So this is the 320 MK, Ryan. A little bit less money, a little bit less fancy, still the same quality, still the same warranty, still Grand Design customer service. So let me know what you and other involved parties might think. No heating vents in the floors, as you know. A little bit longer, but lighter. A little bit different, but kind of the same. 406-696-4750. Let's go camping.